An automotive exhaust system is a critical component of a vehicle's powertrain that manages and expels the byproduct of the internal combustion engine. It plays a crucial role in maintaining engine performance, optimizing fuel efficiency, and reducing harmful emissions. An exhaust system consists of various components working together to guide, treat, and release exhaust gases safely into the atmosphere. SimScale is a cloud-native simulation platform that can be utilized for analyzing and optimizing various engineering problems, including automotive exhaust systems. By leveraging SimScale, engineers and designers can validate different designs, meet performance requirements, and reduce development time and cost effectively. Examining and comprehending the flow pattern, back pressure, and the temperature distribution in the initial stages of the exhaust design system enables engineers to implement crucial design adjustments according to specific needs. In the next few minutes, we'll be looking at how to utilize SimScale to run an exhaust system analysis and derive the key insights. Here, we'll be comparing two different designs of exhaust system, the base case being a double chamber typical exhaust system, and the design 2 will be modified on the muffler to have three chambers. We'll be also looking into multiple flow rates ranging from 200 to 420 kilograms per hour, which corresponds to different acceleration rates of the vehicle. For this case, we'll consider the ambient temperature to be 45 degrees Celsius, and the key insights will be the exhaust back pressure, the exhaust performance based on temperature and flow turbulence, and we'll also look into how efficiently we can simulate multiple design scenarios in parallel. Let's explore the SimScale platform together to review the simulation results and see how we can easily set up these simulations within a few steps. We are right now in the post-processing scene of SimScale and looking at the base exhaust system model. The first thing I'll notice is the temperature distribution starting from the inlet of the exhaust system until the tailpipe. Looking at the inlet temperature, which is around 500 degrees Celsius, you can already see there is a reduction of temperature or loss of temperature due to convection in the inlet section of the exhaust system. Moreover, looking at the muffler itself, there is a huge gradient again. This might be due to the reason that the muffler doesn't have proper perforations between the two chambers. You can also extend these insights at different sections of the muffler or the exhaust system to find out how much temperature can we actually extract from the exhaust gas using this exhaust system. Let's take a look at the temperature right at the end of the inlet pipe. You can use the statistics to find out the maximum, minimum, and average temperature at that particular location. This is around 441 degrees Celsius of temperature. And from 500, we already lost 50 degrees Celsius before entering the muffler. Let's take a look at the same at the end of the muffler to find out how much temperature the muffler was able to take out from the system. It's about 408 degrees Celsius, which means we lose up to 40 to 42 degrees Celsius just because of the muffler. This can be also done at the tailpipe and see the overall loss in temperature throughout the exhaust system. Additionally, if you take a look at the flow patterns within the system, you can find out local effects happening near the perforated cylinders, which is helping the mixing of temperature within this same chamber. And on the other chamber, the color is mapped with blue, which means the velocity is closer to zero or recirculating within the same chamber. This will lead to poor performance in terms of fuel residuals being clogged into the muffler system. To improve this, we have modified the case with a triple chamber muffler system, and let's take a look at how this flow pattern will be improved with a triple chamber system. Thanks to the compare option, where we can actually start comparing two different designs side by side within the SimScale post-processor. Let's open up the same flow rate for the second design, and this will load the results side by side on your SimScale platform. Once when both the results are loaded on the platform in the compare mode, you can have a synchronized view to take a look at the results on both the designs. On the left, we have still the base design with two chambers, and on the right, we have the three-chamber variant of the muffler system. Here you can already see there is a proper mixing of exhaust gases between the three chambers, and when looking at the temperatures at these locations, you'll be able to see how it has improved the distribution of temperature within the system. On the left, you can see the second chamber is so cold when compared to the first chamber, and on the right, with the introduction of two more chambers, here the temperature gradient seems pretty smooth, which means there is a proper mixing of the exhaust gases, and that will improve the efficiency of the overall system. For the next few minutes, we'll look at the simulation setup and see what we need in terms of user input to start such a simulation. For any CFD or FEA simulation within SimScale, the starting point will be the import of 3D geometry. SimScale supports 3D file formats, native or generic, from almost all the CAD tools available in the market. Here in our case, we use a parasolid file as a solid input, and we have generated the fluid volume that is used for the simulation. Once when the CAD model is ready, you can select the physics that you want to use for the simulation. SimScale does support various application types, including solvers from different backgrounds to use for a simple flow analysis up to a conjugate heat transfer analysis, which couples the solid and a fluid temperature. You can also do structural analysis ranging from static to frequency or thermomechanical analysis. For this case, we select the conjugate heat transfer analysis to include the conduction and convection part in the simulation. Creating a simulation will give a simulation tree on the left, which will then guide the users to set up the inputs and start the simulation. Here we have only one fluid as an input. We go with the air, where you can start modifying the properties according to your requirements. We also have one inlet condition that is going to be applied at the inlet section of the exhaust system with the proper temperature and the flow rate. We cover the outlet section with a pressure outlet to identify at what temperature the exhaust system releases the exhaust into the atmosphere. We can also add multiple boundary conditions based on the insulation materials used in the exhaust system. So this can be done under the wall boundary condition, and we can start to set either a fixed heat flux or a derived heat flux, where you can define the heat transfer coefficient and the ambient temperature as well. Once when all these settings are done, you can directly go ahead, start the simulation, and find out how much time it might take to run the simulation. Let's quickly jump back to the design and start a simulation to get a rough estimation of how much time this is going to take. For this case, SimScale estimates about 15 to 22 minutes of simulation runtime and the computing resources. If you're happy with that, you can go ahead and start the simulation. In addition to what we have started now, as we've mentioned, we'll be also looking at different flow rates depending upon the acceleration of the vehicle. This can be easily set by getting into the boundary condition where we define the inlet exhaust flow rate. And instead of giving one value, you can now introduce parametric values with different flow rates, either from a CSV file or simply typing in into the table. This way, when you start a simulation, you're not just starting one flow rate, but you are starting three different variants of flow rate, which will run in parallel on the cloud. After the results are there, you can start comparing them together and use the post-processes as we have done previously.
I hope this gives a good idea on how to run an exhaust system analysis using SimScale and use the results for design improvements. Thanks for listening.